Save Our Schools Arizona is a local volunteer group formed by six moms in 2017 to fight a massive expansion of the state's private school voucher program known as Empowerment Scholarship Accounts, or ESAs. In spite of our overwhelming victory with Prop 305 in 2018, lawmakers and special interests have doubled down on attempts to expand ESA vouchers, even out of state. Now, Save Our Schools Arizona is leading a statewide citizens initiative to reform the ESA voucher program and prioritize Arizona's public schools once and for all. Will you help us save our schools? Getting ready. Arizona's lawmakers keep making it harder for citizens to exercise their constitutional right to place measures like ours on the ballot. Please listen closely and follow these instructions exactly so that every signature you collect counts. Follow these four simple steps. Step one, anyone can circulate petitions in Arizona as long as they're qualified to register to vote in Arizona. So you need to be a U.S. citizen, at least 18 years old, and you must be able to write and sign your name. You cannot be a convicted felon. And if you are not a resident of Arizona, please contact us for further instructions before circulating a petition. Step two, grab a clipboard, your black or blue ballpoint pen, no Sharpies allowed, and an official Save Our Schools Act petition. Step three, next, immediately check the volunteer box in the top right corner of the petition. Also, fill in both county blanks on the front of the petition sheet with the county in which you will be circulating the petition. The volunteer box and two county lines must be completed before you begin getting signatures. If you are being paid to gather signatures for any effort, please contact us as soon as possible for further instructions. Step four, make sure the petition is securely stapled to two sheets containing the title and text of the initiative. These must stay attached at all times. If the petition is detached from the stapled sheets, none of the signatures on that page will count. It's also important to note that you do not complete anything on the back of the petition form at this time. Here's how to get signatures. As a volunteer circulator, your job isn't just to get signatures, but to get signatures that count. Think neat and complete with every single signature. Here's what all circulators need to know. Only signatures of registered Arizona voters count toward the goal of the 237,000 valid signatures needed. So be sure to ask each person you approach, are you a registered voter in Arizona? Also, each petition sheet is limited to one county, and all signers of that petition must be registered in the county listed. So be sure to ask, are you registered to vote in Maricopa County, or are you registered to vote in Pima County, and so on. If you're attending a large event, you may want to have one clipboard for each county. For signatures to count, each line must be filled out neatly and completely only by the signer. No other individual can complete any portion of the signature line. The only exception is assisting a person who is incapable of signing or printing his or her own name and specifically requests assistance. Please make sure your signers fill out each section completely. Missing or incomplete information like the city or the date is grounds for the rejection of a signature. Signers must also provide their actual physical address. Signatures with a PO box for an address will not count. If a signer does not have a street address, the signer may provide a description of the location of their residence. Signers must also use a complete date. A date that simply says 3/17, for example, may cause that signature to be rejected. Please pay attention to the dates that signers are placing on the petition sheets. Oftentimes, when one petition signer uses an incorrect date, others will follow. So don't rush and ask your signers to be neat and complete when they sign and to keep the majority of their signature within the box. Remind them to use their full legal signature that matches their voter ID and double check to make sure that each box is filled out completely. Be sure to show your signers that the zip code comes before the city. Remind them not to abbreviate the city name. If information is entered in the wrong box or your signer makes a mistake, just ask them to draw a line all the way through the incorrect line and start over on a new line. The petition sheets that you carry are your responsibility, and you must personally witness each signer signing his or her name and completing all of the entries on the petition sheets. Do not leave petition sheets unaccompanied at any time or pass them around. Finally, be sure to thank the signers for exercising their constitutional right to put an initiative on the 2020 Arizona ballot to save our schools and to demand that our elected officials make public education a priority. Ready to turn in your petitions? A petition is a legal document, and signing this form means that you are promising that each person signed in your presence and to the best of your knowledge, all the information is correct and completed only by the signer. Do you have petition sheets with blank lines still available? You can still turn petition sheets in that aren't full or only have a few signatures, but once your petition is signed and notarized, you may not add new signatures. If any signature shows a date after it's notarized, the entire petition will be disqualified. To make sure all your signatures count, you must complete the backside of your petition in the presence of a notary public who will then notarize the form. Do not sign the back of the petition sheets in advance. So here's the back of a petition. Make sure to clearly fill out all the information. Print your name here and the county where you live here, then sign here and include your complete mailing address. Again, PO boxes are not allowed. Sign here using your full legal name and the signature that matches your voter ID. And when you're done, the notary will then notarize the document. Thank you for helping us save our schools. Together, we can create strong schools for a strong state. We can do this.
We're here to help. Take a look at the Save Our Schools Arizona fact sheet or watch this video again. If you have any questions, please contact your volunteer coordinator or email us at info@teamsosarizona.com. Also, check out the October 2019 Arizona Secretary of State's Petition Circulator Training Guide online at azsos.gov. Paid for by Save Our Schools Arizona, not authorized by any candidate.